Happy Sabbath, boys and girls. Welcome back to another children's program. I am happy to have each and every one of you joining us this morning. Now, for our program today, we will be discussing GPS, God's Powerful Scriptures. Has anything ever gone wrong in your life? Even when you're faithful to God and doing what you should do, like being kind to others, helping others, going to church, things still go very wrong. What are some of the things that have gone wrong in your life? Maybe you failed a test you studied so hard for, or you were falsely accused of doing something that you did not do. Maybe your best friend or a close family member got sick and died. Or your parents may have lost their jobs. In a matter of moments, a very short space of time, life could spiral out of control and become very chaotic. In these moments, finding and trusting God may seem very hard, isn't it? The waters of life can be choppy and difficult to navigate, especially for us as children. But there is hope, and we can learn how to find our way out of these difficult times. Men made a global positioning system to help us to find our way from one place to another. But God has given us a map for life called the Bible. It is filled with GPS, God's powerful scriptures, to help us get through the most difficult situations. God is here. He is able and He understands. At this time, join with me for our opening hymn, hymn 286, Wonderful Words of Life.
Sing them over again to me, wonderful words of life. Let me more of their beauty see, wonderful words of life. Words of life and beauty, teach me faith and duty. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Christ the Blessed One gives to all wonderful words of life. Sinner, list to the loving call, wonderful words of life. All so freely given, wooing us to heaven. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Sweetly echo the gospel call, wonderful words of life. Offer pardon and peace to all, wonderful words of life. Jesus, only Savior, sanctified forever. Beautiful words, wonderful words,
Amen. At this time, I invite LaShawn Wilson to give us the scripture reading.
The scripture reading is taken from Isaiah 43, verses 2. When you go through deep waters and great trouble, I will be with you. When you go through rivers of difficulty, you will not drown. When you walk through the fire of oppression, a feeling of being heavily weighed down in mind or body, you will not be burned up. The flames will not consume you. Here ends a portion of God's word. Jesus, please protect us and those that people are doing bad things, and they're just doing bad things. That God, please protect us from this virus. This virus what kills millions of people. God, people are trying to fight back. This virus is too strong for us, and we know that only you can take away it, God. Don't let the devil rule over us. Please protect us in this world. Please, God. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
At this time, we invite Jamoy Williams with a mission story.
Our mission report for today comes to us from the country Cyprus, and it's entitled Praying for Pets. So some children, they wanted pets, and they went to their parents asking them for a pet. And mother said no, and daddy also said no. And they were sad, but they continued asking each time, "We want a pet." And mother said no, daddy said no. And one day they decided to pray about it. And the next day, a neighbor, she had cats, and her cat had kittens. And the kittens, they found a way over the house. And the kids, they saw it and said, "Oh, God answered her prayers." And they were happy that they had the kittens, and the parents saw the kittens and they didn't refuse them. They accepted them into the family, and the children, they got pets. And it just goes to show that whatever you want or whatever you need, you should ask God for it, and God will provide it for you.
Amen. Indeed, boys and girls, we realize that God truly answers prayers. There was a time in my life too when my faith was tested. I remember this day when a group of my non-Christian friends and I, we were sitting, we were chatting. Suddenly, we came across a topic that they weren't familiar with. No, because I knew that we can find God's messages on that particular topic in His words, I shared my belief with them. Now, after sharing my belief with them, can you imagine, boys and girls? They were laughing, they were mocking, laughing again and mocking again. But I remained calm because I was reminded in God's scripture that He will stand for me. And in Romans 8, verse 31, it says, "What shall we then say? If God be for us, who can be against us?" At this time, we invite our children to come and tell us how we can use God's GPS to navigate life.
GPS for loss of a loved one. One of the most painful things that can happen to anyone is losing a loved one. A young boy was swept up in flood waters on his way home from school. The members of his family were all Christian who were praying for God's will. Unfortunately, the little boy lost his life. Do you think God's GPS can be used to comfort this family and friends? Let us see. Psalms 34, verse 18. The Lord is close to the heartbroken and save those who are crushed in spirit. Psalms 147, verse 8. He heals the heartbroken and binds up their wounds. Revelation 21, verse 4. He will wipe your tears away from your eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of the things are passed away.
Our GPS for illness. A teenager observed her mother feeling sick. Her condition slowly got worse. When her mother was finally convinced to visit the doctor, she learned she had stage 3 ovarian cancer. What GPS could be used to comfort the family? The first one is John 14, verse 27, and it says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let them be afraid." The second one comes to us from Jeremiah 30, verse 17, and it says, "But I will restore you to health and heal your wounds, declare the Lord." The final one is from James 5, verse 14 and 15, and it says, Is anyone among you sick? Let them call the elders of the church to pray over them and anoint them with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer offered in faith will make the sick person well. The Lord will raise them up. If they have sinned, they will be forgiven. So, God have promised to heal us, but we must believe and proclaim his promises.
Listen carefully now as we study in depth God's powerful scriptures.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. My name is Ryan Bowers from the Albion Seventh Day Sabbath School Primary Class. Today's review is lesson 13, topic Balaam and the Talking Donkey. Message: we worship God when we follow his instructions. Memory verse: John 14 verses 23. Anyone who loves me will obey my instructions. The Israelites were nearing the promised land. But the surrounding nations had tried to stand in their way, forcing the Israelites to war with them. But God was on their side. Moab was one of those nations, and Balak and Balak was the king.
No, King Balak knew he didn't have any hope of winning the Israelites. He desperately needed help, so he remembered a man named Balaam. Balaam believed in God and was once a prophet. Whatever he blessed was really blessed, and whatever he cursed was really cursed. So Balak thought he would get Balaam to curse the Israelites so that they would lose the war and he would win.
Balak sent his messengers with gold to pay Balaam for the servant service. Balaam had become greedy and no longer served God. But even though he didn't serve God anymore. When the messengers came, he asked God for instructions as to what he should do. And God told him not to go with the messengers and not put any curse on the Israelites because he has blessed them. King Balak sent more messengers with much more silver and gold. Remember, Balaam was greedy, and when he saw all the money, he remembered he really wanted to go, but didn't want to disobey God either. So that night, God told him he could go with the messengers, but he could only do what God told him to say to do.
Balaam set off on his donkey. As he was going, an angel appeared in the road in front of the donkey. The donkey saw the angel and turned right off the road, and Balaam beat the donkey to get back on the road. The angel appeared a second time, and the donkey moved against a wall, smashing Balaam's foot. Balaam beat the donkey again. The angel appeared a third time, and the donkey lay down in the road, and Balaam beat him again. At this time, the donkey began to speak. "What have I done to you? Why you beat me three times? You have ridden me for years. Have I ever done anything like this before?" Balaam was shocked, and at that time, Balaam saw the angel. "I would have killed you a long time if your donkey hadn't turned away," said the angel.
Balaam wanted to turn back, but the angel told him to continue on his journey. But he's to remember to say only what God wants him to say. When Balaam reached, he told Balak that he can only say what God wants him to say. Balak asked him to curse the Israelites. But every time Balaam opens his mouth to curse, blessing comes out on the Israelites. Instead, after the third time, King King Balak realized his plan to overthrow the Israelites wasn't working. And so he became very angry and ordered Balaam to leave and go home.
Okay. This story
teaches us
that worship involves everything you do.
It is living and after.
It is living a life.
It is living a life that is pleasing
to God.
Listening to His voice and following His commands. It is using our voices, speech, and our actions and to honor God.
Amen.
Good morning, boys and girls. My name is Royce Campbell and I will be doing the children's lesson for this week. The topic for this week is Welcome Back, Jesus. The power text is, Men of Galilee, they said, why do you stand here looking into the sky? This same Jesus who has been taken from into heaven will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven. The PowerPoint. God's Spirit empowers us to tell others about the blessed hope of Jesus' soon return. Our story this week tells us about Wesley who lost his grandpa. He was sick and in pain before he died. Wesley and his family were very sad. They missed him a lot. However, they were reminded of Jesus' soon return to earth. If he lived a life in Christ, we would see his grandpa young and healthy again. We too have this blessed hope of Jesus' return to earth. If we are faithful, we see our loved ones who died in Christ again.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. I hope you're having a good Sabbath this morning. I'm Janessa Walker, and this morning I will be doing a lesson review of the early teens class. This week's lesson was entitled, Success God's Way. The memory text is, He who is of a proud heart stirs up strife, but he who trusts in the Lord will be prospered. He who trusts in his own heart is a fool, but whosoever walks wisely will be delivered. Proverbs 28, verse 25 and 26. The story talks about a man named Dave Javecki. He entrusted his life every morning to God. When a cancerous tumor in his arm threatened to cut his career short, Dave didn't demand to be healed. Instead, he committed himself to God's will, and his quiet faith was a witness to millions. God worked a miracle for him. Although his cancer operation required the removal of muscle that he used for pitching, against all odds, he came back to play. But the comeback miracle lasted less than a week. Dave was playing in Montreal, winning the game, when he suddenly pitched his arm broke. He collapsed in a heap. The whole crowd heard that awful snap of bone. As they carried Dave off the field, he quietly affirmed his faith in God. The faith did not waver during long months of uncertainty. Finally, the doctors determined that they had no choice but to amputate his arm, and they did. Did Dave become bitter when God did not heal him? Not at all. Secular sports writers around the country marveled at his faith, solid as a rock. God displayed a miracle greater than physical healing in the amazing display of Dave's contented commitment. The Apostle Paul experienced this rock-solid faith. He too suffered from inaudible physical affliction. 3 times he asked God to miraculously heal him. God's response was plain. My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Paul's answer is remarkable. I will rather boast in my infirmities. I take pleasure in distresses for Christ's sake, for when I am weak, then I am strong. Like Dave and the Apostle Paul, God invites us to hang on to him today with the hand of faith. So let us all be faithful to God this morning and for the rest of our lives. Please do have yourself a wonderful Sabbath.
Wonderful, merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend. Who would have thought that a lamb could rescue the souls of men? Oh, you rescue the souls of men. Counselor, Comforter, Keeper, Spirit we long to embrace. You for whom when our hearts have hopelessly lost our way. Oh, we've hopelessly lost our way. You are the one that we pray. You are the one we adore.
promises are true and claim them for ourselves. Do you believe God's promises are true? Yes, very good. God promises to help us, but we must first trust and obey him. Boys and girls, remember, things will not always be easy. Trouble will come. But if we use God's GPS, we will grow and be strong in Jesus. So whatever happens, let us use God's GPS to make us strong and ready for anything, especially for heaven. Bow your heads with me. Dear Heavenly God, we thank you for your words. We thank you for the peace and comfort they bring. I pray, Heavenly God, that we as children will read your words daily. We trust that you will be with us. We have faith in your words and we rely on your promises. Be with us as we journey throughout the remainder of your Sabbath. Thank you for all that you have done for us, and we leave our lives totally into your hands. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.